aboard a small steamer that passed through the stormy seas of the Indian Ocean. We were on our way to Gaul to solve a case of a vanishing elephant. It was in the summer of 1921 when we had left Liverpool and aboard a steamboat called Lucifer. It was not a large ship, and as both English Channel and Bay of Biscay proved, it was somewhat, shall you say, unfriendly, and if I might say, quite unpleasant. In fact, before we had left the Guernsey, I had spent the whole time in my cabin. However, the weather cleared up, and I decided to come out and on deck and show the poems. It was our second night in Guernsey. We paced the decks together. The stars above us twinkled, the promise of a bright tomorrow. The faint sound of piano tinkled as it played through the passenger lounge, and it made the perfect setting for leaving shore.
Watson, it's good to see you on your feet again.
It's good to be on them, Holmes. It's been a miserable trip for me so far.
The captain said we can expect good weather between here and Oliver, our next port of call.
Where it's just Oliver, would it be called? I've never heard of such a place.
It's a tiny island in the Bay of Biscay. It's a French protectorate. Those are the only facts I was able to glean from the encyclopedia of the ship's library.
Do you know why we're stopping here?
No, I don't. As we're travelling incognito, it was not to ask too many questions.
We find it incognito to be somewhat of a strain every time a student calls me Mr. English. I don't know who on earth he's talking to.
But I find myself entering into the microphone almost automatically. By the way, old chap, now that you're mixing with the ship's passengers, I suggest you adopt a Scotch accent, as it would seem more appropriate for Mr. Hamish. And I don't want anyone aboard to suspect our true identities.
I'll do my best, Holmes, but I think you're being unnecessarily mysterious.
Well, possibly I've been influenced by reading too many of your rather florid stories about our adventures together.
Our stories are not florid, they're all perfectly true.
Oh, don't be angry with me, old chap, and be angry, please. By the way, you'll be interested to know, I've unearthed a little mystery aboard this ship.
I don't know where she is.
What?
I mean, where it is.
Oh, you observe that suite of cabins on the bridge deck above us?
Yeah,
well, I've been observing them during my nightly stroll over the past 2 weeks. The suite is occupied, and yet the blinds are never raised, and I've never seen any meals taken in there.
Very mysterious, but they're probably occupied by some wealthy invalid.
Possibly. Another interesting fact is that the occupants are not listed on the ship's passenger list.
It's all very interesting, and there's probably a perfectly simple explanation for it. In any case, you must save your energies for what awaits us in France. Remember, you Mr. Mycroft now.
I will, Mr. Hamish.
Mr. Mycroft?
Yes, Mr. Hamish?
Would you care to join me for a week of a bad answer?
Mr. Hamish, I shall be delighted.
Ah, this is excellent, brandy, excellent.
Watson, do you notice that rather garrulous gentleman over there in the corner?
You know one at the table with the wealthy looking fellow?
Yes, the talkative man is the ship's doctor, but I haven't seen the other gentleman before on this voyage.
I wonder if there's some occupant for that bridge deck suite.
Yes, let's go and talk to him, shall we? And remember the accent, Mr. Hamish.
And so, Dubois, when we landed at Bordeaux, I decided to take Mrs. Agatha for a moonlight rickshaw drive from the Cinnamon Gardens. Did you gentlemen want to see me?
If you'll excuse us, Dr. Harris, my friend Mr. Hamish and I were having a little argument and thought perhaps we might be able to settle it for us.
An argument? Oh, I love a good argument! Sit down, gentlemen! This is Mr. Dubois. How do you do, gentlemen?
Good evening, sir. My name is Mr. Hamish, and this is my friend, Mr. Mycroft.
I'm so happy to meet you, gentlemen.
Now, how do you do, Mr. Dubois?
Now, gentlemen, tell me what you were arguing about!
Well, it wasn't a good argument.
Yes, it wasn't exactly an argument. You see, my friend Mr. Hamish insists that the Suez Canal was built by a Dutchman in 1870. I'm convinced that it was built by De Lesseps, a Frenchman, in 1869. We thought you'd know.
You flattered me! I'm only a ship's doctor, not a historian. Ask Dubois.
He probably knows. Can you settle the question for us, sir?
I can, Mr. Michael. You know what's correct. The canal was opened in 1869, though its construction began 10 years previously. Still, it is a French engineer was in charge of the operation. There is a statue of him in Port Said Harbour built to commemorate his skill and enterprise.
I'm much obliged to you, Mr. Dubois. Hamish, I think I'm in my bed.
I hope, I'm afraid you do. You're too short of your glass, Mr. Dubois.
And you should be sure, friend. Miss Gear came to venture small wager myself.
No, no need to make any more of that summer subject, thank you.
Oui. Well, gentlemen, if you'll excuse me, I shall return to my cabin now.
No, I don't go to war!
You can simply drift me away.
Oh, not at all, Miss Jacqueline. I enjoyed making a book, but I have some letters to write. Good evening, gentlemen.
He's a charming person.
Charming and extremely knowledgeable. A bit of a bore, if you ask me. You two fellas enjoy your trip.
I'm just beginning to. It takes a little time to get my sea legs, you know.
Dr. Harris, how long have you been on this ship?
For 4 years. This is my third trip based on this boat.
What? Well, there's something that puzzles me on board this ship. I'm not sure that you would explain it to me.
And what is it?
Sweet cabins on the bridge deck. Who occupies them?
Wouldn't you like to know?
I ain't got them woods, but that's why you try that too.
Well, I'll tell you, though it's supposed to be a secret. But there'll be no harm in telling you now, for we're dropping anchor off Island of Oron in the morning. In that suite of rooms, is the Duchess of Oron herself. She has her own staff of servants and everything. What do you think of that?
Oh, very interesting. And is the worthy gentleman who left the table when we arrived part of her entourage?
He is, sir. He's sort of a prime minister of Oron. This whole trip of theirs is very hush-hush. The Duchess returning to a country afraid someone might make an attack on her life. Have to keep it all hush-hush. Oron's an island that's had a lot of trouble.
You seem remarkably well-informed about the place, sir.
Yeah, I should be. I used to practice there in the younger days.
Very, very interesting.
Yes, I could tell you strange tales about the island. I remember... Oh, hello! See that fellow coming into the lounge?
You mean the big one with the grey hair?
Yes, that's Sir Christopher Wyatt. Owns all the tea plantations in Oron. He's a dull fellow, but I'll call him over. Oi, Wyatt! Come over and join us!
Be careful, he'll talk your head off if you give him half a chance.
Oh, Wyatt, draw up a chair. We were just talking about Oron.
Seems to me like that'd be a good subject to keep away from. At least till tomorrow, Harris.
What do you mean?
You know perfectly well what I mean.
I should have thought that after your own experience on Oron, you'd have learned the discretion.
You're talking like a schoolmaster, Wyatt. Why don't you just sit down, grab a drink, and be friendly?
Thank you. I'll prefer my own company.
Pompous. You and Sir Christopher do not seem to be on the best of terms, Doctor.
I know too much about him. He's afraid of me. That's what he is.
Look at the girl coming in the room. Great Scott, she's good looking.
Judging by her costume, she must be a member of the Duchess and her retinue.
Oh, she's coming to our table.
Yes, my dear, what is it?
Would you be a gentleman and miss you my coffee?
I am.
My mistress sends her compliments and asks that you follow her and her food.
And who is your mistress, may I ask?
Her face, as you say, and all along.
Oh, I shall be delighted. Please tell the Duchess that I will pay my respects without delay. We will join her in a few minutes.
Very well, Miss Hamilton.
You know, Holmes, this is pretty exciting. The girl that brought us that message was a stunning creature. Imagine what the Duchess herself must be like.
What an incurable romanticist you are, Watson. I suppose you picture the Duchess clad in proper splendor and reclining like a goddess in silken cushions.
No need to make fun of me over.
Well, here we are at the cabin.
Ah, it's you, gentlemen. Follow me, please. Her friends, is it you see? All along.
All right, Odette, you come off it.
Yes, your friends.
Well, me lads, don't look so startled. Come in and sit down.
Your Highness,
What's the matter? What's the matter? Don't I fit into your picture of a duchess? What do you expect? A beauty with a veil and big hips. Why not? Big hips, all right.
Your Highness.
Never mind with your Highness. Come in, sit down, and talk free and easy like. I may as well start by telling you that I know who both of you are. Mr. Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson. I've seen you in the good old days of London, you know?
May I ask if our visit is purely a social one, or are you in need of professional advice?
A little bit of both, Miss Holmes, a little bit of both. Let's start off with being social. Pierre, champagne.
I just was wondering, have I seen you before somewhere?
Oh, that's always the question I'm having to answer. Yes, you probably have, Dr. Watson. You see, I was in the chorus of Daily Heaters in London for quite some time until the Duke of Oberon decided that I'd look better on his island than I did in front of the footlights.
Your husband, the Duke, is dead, isn't he?
Yes, he was ill playing Pelda.
Champagne?
Champagne. He doesn't speak much English, so I'm telling you me troubles. Miss Holmes, I think somebody's trying to kill me.
Kill you? That's Scott.
May I ask what reason you have for saying that, madam?
Yes, you may, Miss Holmes. I had the team's threatening letters that said if I ever went back to Oberon, I'd never get to the island alive. Or another letter in Port Said that said the same thing.
You kept these letters, I trust.
No, I didn't. I tore them up. I never did pay attention to letters that wouldn't sign.
That's a pity, madam. Those letters might have been invaluable.
Never mind that now, Dr. Watson. Here's what's on my mind. We land in Oberon in the morning, and if anyone's up to no good, tonight is their last chance.
You had destroyed the threatening letters, madam, thereby indicating you did not believe in the threats. And yet, now you do appear to feel you are in danger. I wonder what made you change your mind.
The Ace of Spades.
The Ace? I don't understand you, madam.
In the last 2 days, every time I tell my fortune, I always get the ace. You know what that means? Death!
Come now, madam, if you'll pardon me saying so, it's a very childish superstition.
The cards have never lied to me yet. Oh, you can laugh at it if you like, but I know!
Well, do you mind if I ask you some questions?
Aye, aye, Miss Holmes.
How long is it since you were at Oberon?
About 18 months. We were in England when my husband died. And I couldn't face the idea of going back to the island alone 3 months ago to Dubois. Oh, he's the chief minister of Oberon.
Oh, yes, we met him for a moment at the lounge.
Dubois came over from England to persuade me. It was my duty as the Duchess to go back.
I see. As far as you know, have you any enemies among the passengers aboard the ship?
That's an odd one to answer, Mr. Holmes. But there's someone in me suite who doesn't like me. That girl, Odette? The one who brought you the message? She was in love with the Duke herself. And I know she hates me. Although, she did stay with me in England when my husband died.
How about Dubois?
Oh, he's all right. My husband got the world of him. And he's been wonderful to me.
He came from Oberon recently, you say, to persuade you to return there?
Yes, that's indeed correct, Mr. Holmes. Looks like Pierre's all right after drinking that champagne. It should be safe for us to have some now.
Madam, I've been meaning to ask you, but why did he get a glass in which we didn't have any?
Surely that's obvious, Watson. He is the official poison taster, isn't he, madam?
That's right, Mr. Holmes. He tastes everything I eat or drink before I do, and if he's all right, then I know it's safe. On the island of Oberon, poison is quite a hobby, you know?
There are two people in the smoking room who seem to know quite a lot about your island. The ship's doctor, a rather garrulous gentleman by the name of Harris, and Sir Christopher White, who owns tea plantations on the island. Do you know either of them, madam?
I should say I do, both of them. Dr. Harris isn't any good. He was on the island for some time, but he got into a bit of trouble and my husband had him thrown
out. How about Sir Christopher White?
Oh, Chris is all right. You know, I saw quite a bit of him in London after my husband's death. Oh, I don't think he'd be on the boat at all. You see, for visits he had with my husband for over 5 years, over the wages he paid the native labor.
It seems to me several people aboard this ship have a personal interest in the island of Oberon.
Just what I
interest that might be influenced by your death.
Just what I was going to say. Madam, I think we should keep an eye on you.
Oh, that's just what I'm hoping you say. You see, I'm having a bit of a supper party tonight, and everyone we've discussed has been invited. And I thought that if you two were here, then maybe you could be on the lookout for any funny business?
Oh, of course we will, won't we, Holmes?
I think it might be a good idea. Although I suggest we retain our incognitos as Mr. Hamish and Mr. Mycroft.
Whatever you say, Mr. Holmes. All right, let's add that champagne.
You know, Holmes, I remember when she was in the chorus of Daly. She looked stunning in those tights. There was one time I tell you.
Yes. Now, if you don't mind, there is a question I'd like to ask you. Is your medical bag fully equipped with all the antidotes to poison?
Poison? Why would she be poisoned? She has her own poison tester.
My dear Watson, you mustn't ask these questions.
Help! Help! Help!
Quickly! Get back to all that creeping through the companionway! Look! There's two people choking by the rail there!
The others! One of those pushed the other on the companionway!
Good God, his skull smashed in! I'm afraid that he...
What's happened? Sir Christopher White! What are you doing here?
I was taking a stroll, hurry up in this direction, and I came here as fast as I could. Great Scott! This fella's bleeding badly. Must get the ship's doctor at once.
That's hardly necessary, I fear, Sir Christopher.
What do you mean?
In the first place, this man is dead. In the second place, he is the ship's doctor.
Yes, the doctor's skull had been broken in instantly. We managed to get the body back to the boat without attracting any attention. Holmes, after revealing his true identity, was able to hush up the killing until after the Duchess's party. Holmes and I came back to our suite to get ready for the party. Holmes, I remember, was in a suppressed excitement. He spoke quietly and deliberately.
Watson, surely it's obvious why the doctor was murdered.
Well, it isn't obvious to me.
It's elementary, my dear fellow! If you're planning a subtle murder attempt, how wise to murder the one person who might save the victim's life? A doctor.
You keep hopping on poisoning. It seems to me the last way you dispose of the Duchess, everything she touches is first tasted by a poison tester.
Exactly. That's why I call it a subtle murder attempt. Didn't you notice the physical attributes of Pierre, the poison taster?
Like what?
Oh, his unusually glossy hair, his remarkably clear complexion, his plump figure. Look here, just tell me one thing, will you?
What is it?
I presume in your medical bag you have a supply of magnesia.
Naturally.
Do you also have hydrogen ferric oxide?
Of course I do.
Splendid. Let's go out to the party.
Funny things to take to a party, I must say.
It's too true, my dear fellow, but I'm afraid this party may not prove to be as convivial as the Duchess thinks.
Holmes, it's nearly 1 a.m. Everything seems to be going splendidly.
It seems to be going splendidly, Watson, but keep your eye on the Duchess.
Yes, I have. Everything she's tasted has been first tested by a poison tester. Oh! I can use a Christmas bird. Are you having a good time?
Indeed, Mr. Hamish. And you, Mr. Markle?
Oh, the Duchess is the perfect hostess. Who can help having a good time?
I don't think that girl is yet to be here, though. I don't want to say I'm pompous, but she is just a servant girl after all.
Well, possibly the laws and honour are not so strict as they are in London, Sir Christopher.
Oh, perhaps you are right, but I don't trust the girl. There's something shifty about her. I told the Duchess more than once. Oh well, I guess it's none of my business. I think I'll go and persuade the Duchess to sing one of her old songs.
He doesn't trust her, and I don't trust him. I don't think it was an incident that we found near the body of Dr. Harris.
Shh, he calls me what?
I trust you gentlemen to enjoy yourselves.
Oh, very much, Mr. Dubois, thank you. I imagine you must be excited at the prospect of returning to Oleron.
I am, Monsieur Mycroft. Zolone left a few months ago. Distinct mother 3 years.
He came what time we arrived at,
and told that he would be there in 5 hours with your Highness.
Oh, look! The Duchess is going on stage.
Yes, let's listen a little closer, shall we?
Well, Christy has asked me to sing something, and I know me voice isn't what it used to be, and don't I know it. Me spirit's the same, and that's enough to put a number over. All right, boys, here we go. No one to talk with. All on the sound, no one to walk in, not beyond the shop. He is behaving, saying my love, for you, for you, for you. Oh,
Great Scott!
promise you're going to be okay.
That's great. What do you want?
All the symptoms of arsenic poisoning. Now I know at home Zach's going to bring magnesium and ferric oxide.
Oh, darling!
You're not going to die, Adam. I'll take care of you.
I'm tired.
Well done, Watson, old chap. Well done.
Now that she's better, why can't we all go back to our cabins? It's nearly dawn and you've kept us here since 1 o'clock. You have no right to do this, you know.
Possibly not, Sir Christopher. There's still a murderer in this cabin and I don't intend to let him escape.
Mr. Arms, what happened? How could I have been poisoned when Pierre tasted everything first? Why wasn't he poisoned?
For a very simple reason. The murderer has been conditioning Pierre for over a year.
What? What do you mean?
He's been feeding him gradually increasing doses of arsenic until he's finally become immune to the poison.
What an unfitness!
Pierre's glossy hair, his clear complexion and stout figure are all typical of a person who consumes arsenic regularly.
Well, who could have done it?
Only one person had the opportunity.
Well, tell us who that person is.
No, not you, Sir Christopher, not you. You haven't been in London for years, whereas Pierre returned it 3 months ago. Odette has also been in London with her mistress for the past 18 months, remember? The answer is obvious.
You did it, Dubois. You brought the taster over from England. You prepared for over a year before.
Of course I did! Not the mistress in England! And you murdered Dr. Harris! Equally true! Miss Yama, give me the key to the doctor. Oh, good afternoon! Please try on the floor. Do not hesitate. You see this revolver? I should have no compunction in using it, I assure you.
How do you expect to escape, people?
The key, please. Thank you.
You boy, you'll never get away with this, you devil.
Oh, but you're not the half of the room. I shall swim ashore in a minute. You're welcome, my dear Dushin. Stand up, Betsy. Tell me! Thank you.
He's gone!
You're the wrong one! What was I doing? I can't cover!
Drop it, old fellow! Aim your leg or run!
Don't hesitate to shoot! There he is on that lifeboat! He's coming off the rail!
Where'd he go?
Right there on the rail above us, madam! He's going to die!
Give me that revolver, Dr. Watson. Come off down there, Dubois.
Look, look at that! Keep on the left there!
There he goes, he died!
Madam, you shot to kill!
Of course I did. We're in Oleron with us now, and though I may not look like it at the moment, I'm still the Duchess of Oleron.